And we are back with Beyonce today. Now, we're talking Sports Illustrated, and that you were the second African-American woman to grace the cover of the swimsuit issue. But clearly, that was a different standard of beauty than what they were used to.
Yes.
Were you nervous about doing it?
Yes, I was in the beginning. More so because I was, you know, wearing swimsuits. And, you know, I've never done a full swimsuit spread.
Why would the bootylicious girl that my little seventh graders at the school I teach in say, she's hot, Miss Reynolds, she's hot. Why
so
would
cute.
You be concerned about being in that swimsuit?
Well, I mean, I was pretty comfortable after we started, but, mm-hmm. you know, I'm a human being. I'm like, okay, I hope it's, you know, and I'm not the standard pencil thin woman. And I requested a photographer that I felt comfortable with, and they were, you know, they did everything I asked, and we had a good time. But so I got through it, and they all turned out great. The pictures.
And according to a couple of polls that came out, you are the most desirable woman in the world. That's a little bit of pressure.
How do you respond to that, right? I don't know how I feel about that. It's scary.
But doesn't that put a little pressure on little girls? We were talking about that earlier. Because as spectacular looking as you are, and trust me, she is in person.
Thank you.
No one can attain that every day.
No, absolutely not. I mean, you know, we have help. We have the retouching. We have, can you thin me there, point me there? You know, it's just, that's a part of being a
Don't
celebrity.
Say somebody actually pumps you somewhere.
That's just a part of it. Even when you don't ask, they do it. I've looked at covers, I'm like, wow, what is that?
And who is that pretty
who
girl?
Is that?
Who were your role models for beauty back then?
Well, I have to say my mother.
Mm-hmm. You know, you look just like her right now, I'm telling you.
I just thought she was the most beautiful woman ever, and I still do. And I loved Tina Turner, I loved Diana, and I loved glamour and class and elegance. And, you know, I think Kelly from Destiny's Child is one of the most beautiful women in the world. And it's just, more importantly, a happy woman, a smart woman, a strong woman, a confident woman is beautiful. And, you know, the most beautiful, the most physically beautiful woman, when you meet them and they have that thing, that darkness inside, it kind of fades the beauty away. And one thing my mom always taught me, you know, we're all going to grow older, beauty fades, and your beauty from within, you know, is forever, and you have to concentrate and focus on that. So when it fades, you don't go crazy and get depressed, and you have something else to offer the world.
You know, you mentioned some of the icons. You got to play an icon in Dreamgirls. Dena Jones is an icon, a character born of the Broadway stage, and put on film by you. Was that a dream of yours to be that dream girl?
Definitely. I love that character because she was flawed, and because, you know, I had my dramatic scenes where I was able to cry and be more emotional and be someone that, you know, when everyone else was glamorous, had no makeup on, thick eyebrows, funny wigs, and a naive, bright-eyed child. And it was nothing like me, and I didn't recognize myself at all when I watched the film. And I feel like the character has so much growth, and it was just exciting for me to challenge myself and know that, you know, I can act, and my part wasn't, you know, about the vocal ability, it was about the acting, and it was very scary for me because I was out of my comfort zone, but I learned so much from everyone, all of the actors and the director.
It's interesting that you say you're out of your comfort zone, because Dena Jones, the character, is supposed to be set out of her comfort zone. She's a background singer because her voice is soft.
Yes.
Which I found shocking, because vocally, you could clearly have played Effie because your voice is there.
Thank
no
you.
Question about it. But you made the choice to be the secondary character, even though she's the star. Was that a conscious choice? Because, you know, you could have gained the 30 pounds.
Yes, that would have been way more fun than dieting.
Uh-huh. You could have gained the 30 pounds and just blew it out of the water also.
But actually, Yes, I thought the character had so much substance, and people kept saying, was it weird for you to be in the background? No, absolutely not. It was a part of the character, and you know, I had so much fun. It was you know, the time of my life. All of us did.
Mm-hmm. It takes great humility to step back and allow yourself out of your comfort zone. Is that one of the life lessons that you've learned?
Yeah, one thing I've learned, you know, there's nothing good about being comfortable and too safe. I mean, there's something good about being comfortable, but not safe.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I would have never grew if I didn't take risks. And I was scared to do a solo record. I was terrified, but I did it and I learned. And I was scared to do this movie, but I did it and I learned. And I was scared to sing in Spanish, but I did it and I learned. And I keep challenging myself and taking these risks. And sometimes I'm like, what am I trying to prove? What's wrong with me? But I keep growing. And in order to grow, you have to do that.
And when we come back, we're going to talk role models and inspiration with the role model who's an inspiration herself.